What's going on to whoever may be watching this? We're back on the Sixth Men. Welcome back. We're gonna start doing these little intros at the beginning because we kind of just dive into it when the video starts. So basically today we're gonna continue just talking about the playoffs and what we think is gonna happen. Hopefully get some funny little pictures and memes in there. We really are focusing on the Lakers a lot because they're kind of the talk of the town. Down 3-2, LeBron's never lost back-to-back playoff games. He's on the verge of losing his first ever round one, so we kind of focused on that. Obviously we touch on the Heat because I had them in the finals, but hope you enjoy the vid, and I don't know, leave a comment. I guess I'm gonna start saying that we need help. We don't know what we're doing. We're just fucking diving right into this bitch. This is fun, so we're gonna keep doing it. Consistency is key, and see you next time. Today's June 2nd, we're about halfway through the playoffs, and a lot of things are happening that probably didn't expect. Yeah. Four things are, one, see you Heat.
Goodbye Heat. Goodbye Heat.
They were in the finals.
So tonight. Unexpected.
Unbelievable.
They should've won game six. I don't know what that was.
At least game six. Two, Lakers are down 3-2.
Don't want to talk about it. I really don't want to talk about it today, but I'm going to have to. But
Lakers are down.
Not looking too good for my team right now.
It is not.
At all.
They're down 3-2. I have Lakers. I had Suns in six, so that's my most
accurate one.
Accurate one, which at the time of me saying it was probably the least accurate. We also have Knicks down 3-1, and tonight they're playing their game five back at home. I had the chance to actually go to game two at the Garden, the only game they actually won. Maybe I can put some clips in there of that day, which was absolutely insane.
That game is crazy.
I've never experienced anything like that. The fuck you, Trey chants. The fucking Trey is balding.
Trey's balding.
It was one for the books. Honestly, just amazing. But that's something else that's huge right now. The Knicks are down 3-1. A lot of people had Knicks in 5-6.
Watching that game was pretty crazy too. It was mad loud. Like, crazy. Every time they scored, even if they were down like 10, crazy. The place went crazy.
It was so loud.
We heard it through the TV. Like, it was ridiculous.
It was electric. Yeah. I didn't sit the whole entire game. The people behind me for the first half hated me because I wouldn't sit. But by the end of the game, everyone's dapped me up. I got dudes jumping on my shoulders. I was ready to run on the court. I was ready to fuck Trae Young
up. Gassed.
It was way too fun. Another thing we got right here is Clippers are now up, or just tied it.
They're back. Clippers are back. Down 0-2, now they're tied.
It was huge.
Game 5 tonight. Oh my god.
Game 5's tonight?
Yeah, Game 5's tonight.
I said this, it was off camera, but when the Clippers went down 2-0 in the last video, we were sketching a little bit. We were like, oh, this is not a good look for the Clippers at all. But I did say a little something that Kawhi was down 2-0 against the Bucks 2 years ago and just won 4 in a row. And that last game was an absolute burial.
It was a burial.
And I think that's it. I think the Clippers, I might put $100 that they win tonight.
It should be 3-1 right now, not 2-2. They should have won game three. They were up 19 in the first quarter, remember?
Luka came out shooting like 5 for 5.
Sold the bag.
It's Kawhi, bro.
Kawhi's been playing great, though. His best performances, like,
since probably the Raptors. That's only two years ago.
Yeah,
but
he's still in his prime. So.
He's good.
Yeah, Paul George has been playing pretty good. Not George Paul yet.
Yeah,
but
I think it's Rondo in the locker room, just like.
It could be Rondo just chirping at him.
It definitely could be.
A little pit bull running around in there.
To run it back to the Lakers real quick, we're going to talk about their next game, which is going to be Game 6 tomorrow.
What do they need? They need an all-time LeBron performance to win the game. If AD's not there, though. If AD is there, I have them winning. But if AD's not there, we need like a 42-10-8 kind of game. But LeBron scored 40 once this year. A little fun fact, your boy Derrick Rose is averaging more points in the playoffs than LeBron right now. So it's like, LeBron's getting older. He is. I still think he's the best player in the league, though. He could do it, but the thing is, there's no shooters. So when he drives, they all just kind of like crowd him around. And when he kicks out, you have Crusoe like hezzying, trying to pull it. And you got Kuzma, like, who can't guard a park guard, chucking up threes. It's just ugly.
When you have Crusoe shooting like, he shot like 8 threes yesterday.
He shot a lot of threes.
That is just like our favorite line right here. Not a good look.
Not a good look.
Not a good look.
It's not.
When you have Montrezl checking in down 30, shooting step back mid ranges, insert that right there.
Yeah.
And him doing little fucking Kareem hooks. No. It's just.
And you got Alphonso McKinney out there. You don't even know who he is. It just.
First time.
Who is that?
First time I ever saw that boy check in.
Yeah.
I had no idea
Ridiculous.
Who he was.
But Schroeder had to up his game. He had the same amount of points as all of us watching the game right now. He had 0. So did KCP. He had 0.
Schroeder had 0?
He shot 0-9, yeah. And he wants, like, a max contract.
He wants $100 million.
Yeah, he wants $100 million. Like, you're wilding, yo. You're wilding for that.
Schroeder, Montrezl, gone.
Gone. I think, Trezl's definitely gone. Dennis Schroeder, unless he comes out tonight and drops some crazy game... It ain't gonna happen. He's gone, probably. It's sad that it's gonna happen. But Drummond, though, isn't... he's all right. Drummond's all right.
I hate watching Andre Drummond play. Yeah, there's nothing I hate more than watching Andre
Drummond goofy,
play.
He's goofy, but...
It's just... And nothing he does just looks fluent. Everything he does just looks like he's just chucking up a shot. Like, he's the most frustrating player to watch. Yesterday, it was great. Honestly, I've bet the Lakers 3 times in my life. I hate the Lakers. I bet them 3 times in my life, and I'm 0-3 every time I bet them.
That's why I never bet my team, ever.
It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. And what was the stat that you said yesterday? Listen to this one. LeBron's first round stats. What was this?
He's like 16-0 in the first round, and he's never lost a back-to-back.
Yep, well.
In the first round. It happened today.
The back-to-back yesterday. Yep, they lost 2 in a row in the first round, and... They're one away from him getting his first ever.
But if he wins game 6, he win in game 7. You know that. But if he wins, though, there's no way he wins the next game and does not win game 7. So I need to see black jersey LeBron. I want him to get like a bloody nose. So he gets the mask on. Get him gassed. Gasol, you need to play, but you literally can't guard Aiden. You're just too slow. And Drummond, you just can't shoot. So it's just like. It's not a good, and he's like kind of slow too, but
Drummond gets like 4 or 5 offensive fouls a game.
Yeah,
I feel.
And he just
that was cat, but he gets a lot. Like he's always turning the ball over. He's so painful to watch. It's just so disgusting.
It's just they don't really have like a really good center to rely on. I feel like
AD.
I guess he's a center,
a power forward, but.
Drummond's just goofy. Like, he just gets too many foul calls and...
The Lakers are being exposed when Drummond... When not Drummond. Fuck Drummond. When AD or LeBron doesn't play, they just get exposed because they take the heat off of everyone. When you only have to worry about one of them and you have Caruso shooting threes, like, you're fine.
I'm fine with the wide-open threes in the corner. I'm fine with those.
Oh, you gotta shoot those.
But not the off-the-dribble, off-the-screen, pull-it, brick, Caruso, run down. Run right back down, buddy.
Disgusting. Now, something else is CP3 went down again yesterday. I don't know how serious it was.
It's cap.
It looked pretty fucking cap.
Cap, Chris Paul, put the red Yankee cap on, blue Mets cap on, whatever cap on, big ass cap.
It
exaggerated to the max.
It was like, weird when we were watching it, he Wesley Matthews boxed him out and hit him like in the back.
Yeah.
Went down, and when they watched the replay, he's sitting there just holding his arm, and like 5 seconds later, he goes, "Oh!" Like, I don't know what happened.
He got shot.
he literally got shot. It made no sense. I don't know if he was just pissed because he thought it was possibly a dirty play, but they pulled him. The Suns were up by like 30, and I don't know. He went to the locker room, came back onto the bench, but... You never know what that fucking dude is.
He's always
playoffs.
Injured.
So, in my eyes, if AD doesn't play next game and CP3 doesn't play, I'm giving that game 6 to the Lakers. If CP3's out there with no AD, that's a dub for the Suns. But if they're both out there, it's going to be a good game. Yeah. I hope they both play. Because when both of those teams have been playing, like, the games, when everyone's healthy, have been pretty interesting.
Yeah, they have been good. Pretty fun. It's good games.
Yesterday, the Suns were just looking ridiculous. Just shot after shot after shot.
Yeah.
They were hitting everything.
They were hitting everything, and Lakers just couldn't do anything about it. LeBron definitely had not a good game. A lot of losses definitely on him, too. I'm not going to lie. LeBron fan, but he kind of sold the bag. Like, he didn't play too good. But
he was starting wetting threes up.
Yeah, he had like 6 made in the third quarter.
Yeah.
Looking like Steph out there.
He got it down.
Dame last night was crazy.
Today, we woke up with a little
message from the 76ers organization that Embiid has a slight tear in the meniscus. Every time I hear meniscus, I'm pretty sure that's like season-ending.
Yeah, injury. It sounds pretty rough. Like worse than AD's. So.
They said it was a slight tear, and he's gonna be on PT. Like
it's cap.
LeBron might send him a little bit of the HGH and be like,
that's
"Here
cap
you go,
too.
Buddy.
Put it on him, cap."
But 76ers fans and team, that is probably the last thing you'd ever wanted to hear, especially in your big man who's always had problems from waist down between his legs and his ankles, his knees. There's always something wrong.
Always.
And he was one of the lead MVPs, but...
He probably would have came in first if he wasn't injured.
Yeah, he missed a lot of games.
A lot of games. But, he still came in second, too, which is kind of crazy.
Yeah.
All right, so like basically, Embiid, he's out, but they're still going to beat the Wizards, obviously. I think they're going to win tonight, probably. Ben can definitely beat them. They have Tobias Harris. They have like the shooters around them. They're good, but like if Embiid isn't 100% going to the playoffs... They're not gonna win the title. I don't think they're win the conference. They're not getting to the Bucks.
They need them.
The Bucks and the Nets are not beating the Bucks, but they're not gonna beat the Bucks when they meet them in the conference finals. But they need Embiid. They need Embiid to win the title. Last year they lost Embiid in the bubble, and now it's supposed to be a whole remake of it.
Yeah.
So they're back in the bubble. They don't have Embiid.
Yeah, it's gonna be bad. Like if you saw the game the other night, they were fucking playing Hack-a-Ben.
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
Wow, Hack-a-Ben.
That's a new one. I remember I looked up and they just fouled, they inbound the ball, Ben's fouled, and I'm like, no, they're actually gonna start doing this. They did. Ben probably, I think he shot like 5 for 13 from the free throw line.
So ugly. Just worse than Luka, right?
Yeah.
Luka's horrible.
Luka's awful. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Literally makes no sense.
You hit 40 foot.
You gotta be kidding me. Just wait.
Was I sucking LeBron's cock?
He was not sucking LeBron's cock. This motherfucker's gotta hurry up, bro.
Yeah.
He's actually pissing me off. We're talking about Embiid, the meniscus.
They'll get through the series, but they need him 100%, or they're not winning the title. If he's like kind of half in it, Bucks in five. No, six.
Would that, because, so Sixers are versing?
The Hawks or Knicks.
Oh.
Oh, they have to get through. Yo, imagine the Knicks pull off the win. 3 wins in a row versus the Sixers without a healthy Embiid.
Yo,
that would be crazy.
That would actually be insane.
That would be stupid crazy.
If Knicks win 3 in a row, I'm going to Game 7. I will be at Game 7 if the Knicks make it to Game 7.
I might be there too if it's under 500.
But that's future. I hope it happens. But also, speaking of the 76ers with the hurt and beat, like if the Hawks win, I don't want to say when, but it's looking like the Hawks are going to win. The Hawks against the 76ers, I think, would be a better series than people are thinking.
Yeah.
They shoot the fucking shit out of the ball. Being a Knicks fan and watching those games is literally the most heart-crushing thing ever.
That shooters
when
everywhere.
You fucking see Bogdanovich shoot, it just feels like it's going in every
time.
Single time.
Yeah.
When fucking Mohawk Gallinari fucking pops in, like, every shot he takes, it's just so... frustrating because it just goes in every time.
It does. Now he was kind of off last game though.
Didn't matter because everyone else was on. DeAndre Hunter or whatever that's his name, right?
DeAndre Hunter, yeah.
He's nice too. Like
Hawks are doing good, but Knicks have stepped with the game. You know, Randall's gonna play like an all-star. Rose is showing up every game. Like I said before, he's averaging more points than LeBron.
Yeah.
Like Rose is doing great. Barrett has to show up. They're just like their heart's there, but they're just not playing good.
Yeah.
They're just straight up nuts not playing.
Randall, it's all Randall. He needs to be more aggressive than that. But back to the 76ers. They're going to win this round with or without Embiid. But if they verse a healthy Hawks team or a healthy Knicks team without Embiid, it's going to be a lot harder than it needs to be.
Six series, six games.
I would still take the 76ers to win it. but I wouldn't count either Knicks or Hawks out if Embiid is not there every single game. And then if the Sixers would make it to the conference finals and they have to verse the Bucks or the Nets, like, without your fucking star, like, good fucking luck.
Good luck.
Like, good fucking luck. And that can bring us to the fucking Miami Heat, who I had in the finals, and I cannot believe that they actually just got swept. Jimmy Butler, I had high expectations.
He played horrible.
I thought you were
horrible.
I thought that team was on the come around big time after last year. I thought at least Eastern Conference Finals. I know they were like a sixth seed, but they were injured. It seems like they were just saving up for the playoffs, but I don't know if it's the Heat or just dog water.
You're literally free, boxed you, dog water, zero earns, zero PR, you have no earnings, no wager earnings, you're free, you're literally so free, freer than a free sample at Costco, you're dog water, literally so dog.
Or if the Bucks are just, like, ready. And honestly, it could just be the Bucks are that good.
Yeah.
I didn't really think the Bucks were gonna come out like this. Like, they're coming
I'd had the Bucks in four, but I had the Bucks winning in, like, six.
No, they're looking five. Different. Like, they're looking fucking different.
Yeah, so, like, with that being said, Bucks in that second round, it's looking like first game's on Saturday. I got Bucks.
It's going to be a fun series.
Fun series. Bucks in six if they're healthy, but Nets play no defense, so I have no faith in them.
Yeah. But when you see the Nets big three putting up over 100 points, that should be terrifying. One of the biggest difference makers in that series, in my opinion, is going to be fucking Joe Harris.
He is. He is, actually. I'm about to say that.
Why?
Because if he starts hitting shots, and they have to guard him when they drive, they have to guard him.
Exactly.
He's a knockdown three-point shooter.
If you're going to, like, I don't know, if you have that KD, Harden, Kyrie, you can't double two of them at one possession. Like, Joe Harris is hitting shots. It's going to be difficult.
Yeah, it is.
Because they have, the Bucks got, like, Jrue Holiday. And who else? Oh, DiVincenzo just went down.
He went down.
Is he a
starter? He's a starter.
That's yikes. Because he actually is a little bit of a clamp. Not anything crazy, but he can hold someone. Like, he can stay in front of them. Yeah, he can give you issues, make it harder for you.
Yeah.
But obviously, no one's going to be stopping Durant. But then on the other side, no one's going to be stopping Giannis.
No way. He's going to hop step his way through it every single time. If Tatum dropped 50, what is Giannis going to do?
That's facts. And usually,
Tatum was getting wherever he wanted that day. Whatever he wanted.
It was ridiculous. And usually the thing with Giannis is, like, teams will build a wall, but who are you building a wall with?
Blake Griffin?
Yeah.
Blake Griffin.
Yeah.
Oh, my bad. Bruce Brown. Bruce Brown. 6'5".
The next thing.
That must be it. Yeah, Bruce Brown.
It's probably
it. Yeah, that's probably it. You look way
Spencer. What about Kyrie? Yeah.
Oh, Harden, yeah. Harden.
Actually, Harden's a good post defender. But he
ain't building a wall. He's building a short ass wall. That's what he's doing.
But
Durant's the only good defender on that team. That's about it.
Yeah. Durant actually stepped up his defense big over the last couple of years. But I also have, because I had Heat ending up, I had Heat versus the Nets, but obviously the Heat are gone. I actually am going to take the Bucks as well in this one. I hope it's a 7-game series and I'd take Bucks in 7.
Yeah.
I think that you got to play defense. Yeah. Look at any team. Look at what that team is made of, right? Let's look at the Nets. Like, let's go. We'll start all the way back in the day. We got Steve Nash as the head coach. His assistant coach is Mike D'Antoni, who used to coach him back in the Suns. And what were the Suns called? The 7-second offense, and they dogged every team with it until they got to the playoffs and they couldn't play defense.
They never got to the finals.
Never. They didn't get to the finals ever?
What, the
The Suns? Nash never was in the finals?
I don't think he was, no. Let's fact check this. Just pull it up.
We'll see.
Yeah.
Now we go to Harden, who played under D'Antoni in the Rockets last year, who played a 6'8" center.
This all small ball.
All these people, they don't play defense. Kyrie is always hidden in the defense. Durant's a good defender, but the history of this, the players and the coaches on this team is no defense and no all championships offense. Besides Kyrie and KD.
Yeah.
Like, that's it. The coaching is clearly not centered around defense.
Yeah.
You need it to win. Even if you look at those old Warriors teams, like, not the old Warriors teams, like a couple years ago, like Durant, they were still like a top 10, 15
defense.
Yeah,
they were. No, they were.
And even before Durant got there, when they had Livingston, Iggy, who else was on that team? The center, Bogut. Like,
Bogut, rim protector.
Yeah, they were a top 8 defense, I think.
Yeah, it was up there.
This Nets top team, they're going to score the fuck out of the ball, but they're not stopping anyone, and they're not stopping Giannis.
He literally averages 40 and 13 in the regular season against them. Now imagine when he goes into the playoffs.
Yeah.
That's all I'm going
to
say.
And he's already fucking talking smack to James Harden. Love that quote. The Nets have great players. Kevin Durant, Kyrie, and Jeff Green.
Not James Harden.
Yeah,
that's what he said.
Yep.
Bucks in 6.
I have Bucks in 7.
And to end this, Lakers in 7.
Nah.
Lakers in 7.
That's it.